Now for the differences between an IDS and an IPS. An IDS, intrusion detection system, is out of band and simply gets copies of network traffic. It can be as simple as a system getting copies of traffic to inspect through a switch configured to send all traffic to the IDS. The IPS, intrusion prevention system, is inline, so original traffic must pass through the IPS. Since the IDS is out of band, it doesn't add any latency. An IPS adds latency since traffic is processed live. If the IDS sensor goes down, possibly after a target attack, traffic will still flow. If an IPS is targeted, attacked, brought down, traffic might stop right there. An IDS can alert an administrator and even automatically tell a firewall to block traffic based on what it observes. While an IPS can do the same, the IPS can stop traffic dead in its tracks as well. The IPS will still report back to a firewall, so traffic can be filtered a lot earlier than where the IPS is located. The obvious question is, if an IPS can do what an IDS can do, but better, why does an IDS still exist today? Well, an IDS can be like a window into your network traffic. It sits, listens, and collects data that can be used for forensics and analysis. Think of an IPS as a control device and an IDS as a visibility device. Packets collected by the IDS can be subsequently analyzed to gain insight to past or even possible future violations when lots of events are linked together. Both IDSs and IPSs are vulnerable to false positives, which is when normal activities are flagged as malicious, and false negatives, which is when malicious activities are flagged as normal. IDSs and IPSs need to be constantly tuned to minimize both false positives, which will send out lots of incorrect alerts, and false negatives, which won't send out alerts when something malicious is happening. Since IDSs are out of band, a false positive won't stop legitimate traffic in its tracks, which could be another reason why they're used together with IPSs to form a great defense in depth setup. IDSs could also be programmed to just alert an administrator instead of telling a firewall to block certain traffic. This would be preferred by an administrator who would want just the alert and the ability to take action himself instead of letting an IDS make a decision for him. IDSs and IPSs, like firewalls, can be either host-based or network-based. In fact, thus far, we've actually been talking about NIDs, network-based IDSs, and NIPs, network-based IPSs. A host-based IDS, or a host-based IPS, resides on a particular computer and monitors activity on just that host system. It benchmarks and monitors the access, creation, modification, and deletion of key system files, as well as the Windows registry. Unlike a network-based IDS or IPS. Host-based ones can deal with encrypted traffic that will have been decrypted on the host for processing. It can also detect attacks that may elude a network-based IDS or IPS. As you can imagine, this does slow a system down. Generally speaking, a HIPS, host-based IPS, will be looking more for anomalous system activity, while a HIDS, host-based IDS, will be looking more for anomalous network activity. But the lines have become very blurred. Just like a network-based IDS or IPS can catch malicious traffic that either evaded the network-based firewall or originated from within the network, a host-based IDS or a host-based IPS can catch malicious traffic that either evaded the host-based firewall or originated from the inside of the machine. Signature-based IDSs and IPSs act just like antivirus software, trying to detect attacks by looking for patterns. For example, with certain instructions on a host machine, or usage of protocols or content. The obvious problem is that unknown patterns can't be detected, and adversaries are constantly changing their code to avoid simple signature detection. Furthermore, the signature database needs to constantly be updated. Anomaly-based IDSs and IPSs compare an established baseline to something that might be malicious. However, false positives and false negatives are big issues that need to be dealt with through monitoring and tweaking. The latest anomaly-based IDSs and IPSs can detect malicious insiders, as well as machines or accounts that have been compromised from outsiders.